gentlemen, and welcome to meeting of the Board of Election Commissioners of the City of Chicago, ex officio, the Electoral Board. If at any time during this call you need assistance, please press star zero for the operator. This call is being recorded. I would now like to turn the conference over to Jonathan Swain, Commissioner of the Chicago Board of Elections and Electoral Board. Please go ahead.
Thank you. Good morning. My name is Jonathan Swain, and I'll be standing in, chairing this meeting, standing in for Commissioner, Chairwoman Maricel Hernandez, who is also on the call. Let me call to order this meeting, the Board of Election Commissioners of the City of Chicago, constituting ex officio the Electoral Board, to hear and pass upon objections to petitions for questions of public policy and to nomination papers for candidates for the offices of Representative in Congress, State Senator, and Representative in the General Assembly for the November 3rd, 2020 general election. So I'd like to call the meeting in order. Well, we have today with us Commissioner Bill Cressy.
Present.
And Chairwoman Maricel Hernandez.
Present.
Okay. So before we begin the public comment about draft rules of procedure, I'd like Adam Lasker, if you could, the rules of procedure for this electoral board cycle, because of all the things going on with COVID-19, it's going to be a little different. So Adam, if you could summarize some of the changes or differences between our typical rules and these rules before we open up for public comment.
Well, thank you, Commissioner Swain and the board. There are two main categories of newer amended rules, all of which are a result of COVID in the end. First of all, we're going to be conducting hearings by video or audio conferencing, as we are doing by audio conferencing right now. So rule one has been amended to allow for the Electoral Board to conduct its meetings remotely. And then rule two has been amended to allow the hearing officers to conduct their hearings by WebEx. Remote conferencing is how we're going to be doing that. For any of the parties who are listening, we do have the case schedule that's on the website every year, now has a live hyperlink to your individual WebEx hearings. Those will be updated as future hearings get scheduled. We've also made it mandatory this year that the parties provide an email address for receipt of notices and service of documents. And we're requiring that all documents to be filed with the Electoral Board shall be filed by email. If anyone has a legitimate reason for not being able to access email during the proceedings, there is discretion for the hearing officer to find good cause to waive the email requirement. So not only is this necessary for social distancing coronavirus purposes, we've also seen in recent electoral board cycles that the vast majority of the documents are already being filed and exchanged this way. So we think that it will actually please the parties. Now, the second category of changes, which is still related to the coronavirus COVID, is that there was a federal court order from the Northern District of Illinois in the case of the Libertarian Party et al. Versus the state of Illinois. Judge Rebecca Pallmeyer issued an injunctive order that extended the filing period, lowered the signature requirements, and changed some of the other aspects of filing petitions for independent and new political party candidates. So as a result of that, we've created a new Rule 7 in the draft rules, which is entirely related to the Libertarian Party lawsuit. And so that's a rule that addresses the fact that electronic signatures are allowed on petitions for the first time under this court order, which requires some changes to the procedures for how we conduct record exams. There's also obviously the rule changes in regards to the handwriting experts and what their role will be when it comes to an electronic signature being compared to a wet signature. That's the basis of the rules. I would just point out, if you are listening, that the rules to look at for amendments are 1B3, Rule 2, Rule 3C&D, Rule 6. The new Rule 7 is entirely new. Rule 8 is slightly amended. Rule 10C&D, Rule 16, Rule 17 has been amended just because we're not going to have business days on the weekends for this cycle because it's a relatively light docket. Rule 20D, Rule 21, and Rule 22 all have some minor adjustments in it. So that's a summary of the substantive changes to the Electoral Board rules for the proposed draft rules we've circulated along with the calls that were served on the parties. Thank you, Commissioner.
Great. I'll ask commissioners if there are any questions. Let's hold those questions until after public comment, if you could. But now moving into public comment about the draft rules, are there anyone who would like to make public comment on these draft rules of procedure?
Commissioner, this is Adam Lasker. I'm looking at the dashboard for this teleconference call, which indicates whether people have requested to speak or not. The only names of the public I notice on here all have a no next to them. So it's my understanding that means there's no public comment.
Great. So well, thank you very much, Adam. So we'll move on to item D, consideration and adoption of the rules procedure. Commissioners, are there any questions about the rules procedure?
None from Commissioner Cressy.
None from Commissioner Hernandez.
Great. So in light of that, I'll entertain a motion to adopt the rules procedure for the Electoral Board. Is there a motion?
So moved, Commissioner Cressy.
Second, Commissioner Hernandez.
Having been moved and properly seconded, all those in favor?
Commissioner Cressy votes aye.
Commissioner Hernandez votes aye.
Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The rules have been adopted. Okay, moving on. We're going to do a call of the list, call of cases and list of objections. Because it's such a short list, this go round, I will read all of the four cases that are here. First case is 20EBIND01, Nikita Hart as the objector versus the candidate Paris Walker Thomas for the Office of Representative in the General Assembly, 28th Representative District. The next case is 20EBNPP01, Ananacio Gonzalez as the objector versus Mary Brown as the candidate for the Office of State Senator in the 11th Legislative District. The next case is 20EBNPP02, Barry Connolly as the objector versus Glenn Olufsen as the candidate for Representative in the General Assembly, 55th Representative District. And the final case is 20EBNPP03, Natasha Smith as the objector versus Joshua Flynn as the Representative in the General Assembly, 78th Representative District. Those are the cases that are on the docket for this Electoral Board cycle. I'll move on to item F, the appointment of hearing officers pursuant to Rule 2 of the Rules of Procedure. We have four hearing officers that have been assigned or been identified as hearing officers for this cycle. I'll list them now. Barb Goodman, Mary Celeste Meehan, June Brown, and David Katzai. They are the hearing officers that have been identified for this cycle. And for the rules procedure, we need to adopt them as hearing officers. Can I entertain a motion to adopt those four names as hearing officers for this cycle?
So moved, Commissioner Hernandez.
Seconded, Commissioner Cressy.
Having been moved and properly seconded, all those in favor?
Commissioner Hernandez votes aye.
Commissioner Cressy votes aye.
In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. Okay, moving on to item G, assignment of cases to hearing officer and adoption of the hearing officer schedule. So, for case 20EBIND01, we're assigning Barb Goodman as the hearing officer. The location for the hearing will be via video conference, and the hearing date will be begin today at 1 p.m. For case 20EBNPP01, we're assigning Mary Celeste Meehan. The location will be video conference, and the first hearing date will be today at 1 August 7th at 1:30 p.m. For case 20EBNPP02, we are assigning June Brown. That case will be held via video conference, and that first hearing will be set for August 7th, 2020 at 2 p.m. And finally, for case 20EB NPP03, we're assigning David Tadzai as the hearing officer. The hearing will be taking place via video conference, and the hearing date will be today, August 7th, 2020, at 3 p.m. Can I get a motion to approve the assignment of these cases to the respective hearing officers that I just named and the adoption of the hearing officer schedule?
So moved. Commissioner Cressy.
Second, Commissioner Hernandez.
Having been moved and properly seconded, all those in favor?
Commissioner Cressy votes aye.
Commissioner Hernandez votes aye.
In the opinion of the chairs, having no further business before this body at this moment, I would like to entertain a motion to recess to the call of the chair.
So moved, Commissioner Hernandez.
Seconded by Commissioner Cressy.
Having been moved and properly seconded, all those in favor?
Commissioner Hernandez votes aye.
Commissioner Cressy votes aye.
In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. This meeting is now in recess. Thank you very much, Commissioner.
Thank you all very much.
Thanks, everyone.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Until next time.
Yep. Bye-bye.